the secret of the Temple of Solomon. They were the perfecti who protected the esoteric wisdom of the Ark, for they were the Western version of the Eastern Sufi, who themselves protected the Baraka. The only vessel that they spirited away from the ill-fated Monsegur was the vessel of grace, otherwise known as knowledge. In essence, the term Baraka is an original term for art and is thought by many to be derived from the ancient Egyptian boat. The Sufis have often been said to have originated, or at the very least, to have origins in Egypt. And so, having some knowledge of Sufism, we must embark upon a journey into the term, knowing full well that what lay before us is an often contradictory and argumentative subject matter. Sufism, for those who may never have heard the term, is called the way to the heart, which of course means the center. It is the way of the pure, as Sufi may derive also from the word sala, meaning cleanliness or pure. Another viewpoint has the word being derived from the Arabic word for wool, suf, thus implying the cloak worn by the Sufi, or the fact that every Sufi was seen to be a shepherd. It may also come from the Ashab al-Sufa, meaning companions of the veranda, or people of the veranda. The veranda spoken of is the one on the Prophet Muhammad's mosque, and these people of the veranda were said to spend their days in prayer and meditation during the Prophet's lifetime. These special adherents were from many lands, including Persia, Ethiopia, Egypt, and even Rome, bringing a great many diverse beliefs and interests with them. There is, however, a more telling term from which the word Sufi may be derived, Sophia. This concept of wisdom, spoken of again and again in esoteric literature, and which has come down to us today via all manner of faiths and creeds, even into secret societies such as the Freemasons. This version of the name was espoused by Abu Rehan Barumi, a Persian mathematician.